Greetings and welcome speech and welcome to all participants in this webinar. I'll be briefly telling about the role of audit and the number of audit objections, whatever we have in our day-to-day working, and then how CAG report will be prepared. What are the stages involved in that, and how the audit objections or CAG reports are to be answered. I'll show small examples related to the CAG audit report so that we'll have immediate reference for you to understand how these CAG audit reports are dealt. Before starting my session, I would like to show a small clip which audit has given for me as a audit key document, key evidence in support of their draft para observations. So let us first go through that. So, have you seen the clip? I hope you may have seen the clip. Now, this clip was used as a evidence for their audit draft para, where they have given the CDs also for us along with the draft para, and their contention is regarding the time allowed for loading in a SADI. What they observed is, because we are using the chutes for loading the covered wagons, the time allowed should be not manual, it is mechanical. So this is how they prepare the audit reports that we will see later on. But now let us see the first, let us go into the role of audit. So the Controller and Auditor General of India, as we knew, he is the supreme audit authority in in India, and in railways he will be assisted by Deputy CAG I Railways, or normally we call him as DAI Railways. And this Controller and Auditor General of India post itself, it is in our finance code, it was clearly mentioned that it is created sui generis. Sui generis means uniquely. Uniquely this was created. That uniqueness is because of the creation, because of its creation as per constitution article. So as per a constitution article, an organization which is created, we call it as a constitutional body. This is against the statutory body. The statutory body is the body which was created against as a result of a statute passed in parliament. That is different, and this body, like Controller and Auditor General of India, we have Chief Election Commission also. So these are the organizations created as a result of the provisions of the Constitution. So as per Article 148 of the Constitution of India, this the organization has been created. What for this organization has been created? Because this organization has to give its report duly, going through the accounts of the union government, state legislatures, union territories, and then on behalf of common man, how the funds or taxpayers' money is utilized. Similarly, as regards the receipts also, what are the provisions that were there, and whether those, as according to those provisions, the receipts are being accounted for or not. So this is the Supreme Audit Authority main function that was enshrined. Now, where are the functions that were given? So the functions, what they are supposed to do, it was given in Article 149 to 151. So this 149 to 151, what does it say? First one is, it is the duty of the CNDG to audit the receipts and expenditure. So 149, it says that, that means any money that was taken by an organization or given to an organization, say from Consolidated Fund of India, so that, because that is the taxpayer money, so that organization automatically will be audited by CNDG organization. And 150, next article, it says that the form of accounts of the union government or state government or union territory, how it should be done. It will be prescribed by CNDG, and the president will tell that, yes, you have to follow this form and this classification, and accordingly we have to follow. So this is the form and classification will be decided by CNDG. So that is why even you may have observed that in appropriation accounts, one statement will be sending to audit, that whatever changes and forms and changes in forms and classification done, carried out during the year, that will be reflected in that particular statement. So if anything we have done without their knowledge, then they will find out, and then they will give their comments. So that is Article 150. Then 151, that is most important as far as the audit functioning is concerned, because they have they may have examined our accounts, but finally it has to be reported to whom? Reported to the public. So reported to the public means reported to the parliament. So when the report is tabled before parliament, we can say that the findings of the CNDG are in public domain. So when they are in public domain, they can be discussed. The various outcomes, so you may have seen in Bofors or Spectrum or Rafael D, so many items, or for that matter even in railway, suppose catering policy, how we have done. So these things will be widely discussed. So taxpayer money, where we are spending, whether the purpose for which they were given, whether we are doing it or not, if anything wrong that is done, they will point out those mistakes also. So this is how the functions are enshrined. One more important point is that whether the function of CNDG can be taken up or additional function can be given. No, absolutely. It has to be done with the approval of Parliament only. Without that, no function can be taken out from him and no function can be attached to him. That is one of the structure, that is basic structure of the this Supreme Audit Authority of India. Then their duties and powers, they were given, this is DPC, or duties, powers and conditions. Remember these. So these are enshrined in Act 56 of 1971, And later on, it was amended to 58 with amendment of 58 of 1976. So here, the duties are given. So according to those duties only, that can be the CNDG organization will function. Mostly, the duties are to be summed up. We can say that compilation of accounts is one. That means compilation of accounts of union government and state governments and union territories. That is the duty of CNDG. However, you may be getting a doubt. Sir, in railways, we'll be doing the compilation of accounts. Yes, absolutely right. When Aprod committee recommended that this separation, the railway accounts department and audit should be bifurcated. Previously, in those times, the railway used to be under AG Railways. So, when the two departments were separated, accounts and audit functions were separated, the accounts were under the then financial commissioner, and now what we call it as member finance. Then later on, the compilation was retained with the railways only. This is the peculiarity of the railway system, railway accounting system. Whereas the CNDG organization, that is railway audit department, was given the function of scrutiny of the accounts. Whatever we submit to them, they have to scrutinize, or whatever inspections they have to carry out, they will carry out, and whatever reports they compile, they send it to us. And the appropriation accounts, whatever we have given, those appropriation accounts will be scrutinized by them. So this scrutiny only was given, whereas the compilation of the accounts, it was entirely left with the railways only. That is the important function. Then another one is audit of accounts. So this, what will they do? It is the expenditure from Consolidated Fund of India. If anything is there, that the money has been actually spent on the same purpose or not. If not, some reappropriations we may have done. So whether those reappropriations have been done under proper authority. And one more thing is, they also check whether the funds that were made available, they were legally available. So legally available means, as per the constitution, whether the approval of Parliament has been taken, or vote of Parliament has been taken, or the sanction of President of India has been taken. So all these things they will verify. So this is one. And next one is expenditure conforms to the authority which governs it. So the authority which has spent that, whether he is having power or not, that is with reference to SOP they will do. And the transactions related to contingency fund and public account also, they will scrutinize. So then trading, manufacturing and stores accounts, they will scrutinize. Then all the transactions related to receipts. So transaction means both disbursements and receipts. So receipts also, whether whatever tariff is there, according to that tariff, whether we are collecting it or not. So that also they will check, because the money, whatever we have collected, it will be going into Consolidated Fund of India. So this is one that is, and one more important point is that what are the rules and regulations, and whether those rules and regulations are properly implemented, and whatever internal check what we do, it is sufficient. It can unearth whatever problems are there. Those problems can be, or frauds, if any happen, whether the accountant system or internal checking system, can it detect such frauds? So all these things, and the accounts that are maintained, whether they are in proper format, that is prescribed heads, they are operating or not, because we knew that we are government concerned as well as commercial undertaking. So now whatever requirements are there towards commercial accounting, whether we are doing, and whatever six-tier basic structure of government accounting is there, major heads, minor heads, sub-heads, sub-major heads, detail heads. So whether and primary unit. So this is called six layer. This we tell it as a six-tier government accounting system. So whether we are following that or not, they will do that. So, and one more important point is that there is no leakage of revenue or unnecessary expenditure we are not incurring. So these things will be scrutinized by audit. So this is audit of accounts. Then finally, the audit report. So compilation of the audit report, as far as the railway organization is concerned, it rests with the DAI, Deputy Controller and Auditor General of India Railways. He will be working for and on behalf of CNDG. As far as railways are concerned, he will be doing, and the compilation of audit reports, this duty completely rests with Deputy CNDG I Railways. So he while preparing these reports, they have got the liberty to call for the oral evidence and elicit information. They can question and they can take written answers. So everything, these powers are there with them. So this is how it will be done. And the in charge officer, whoever is there, when they come for inspection, or if they want some information to be given, all that has to be provided, and we cannot cause any hindrance to their working. If we are causing hindrance to their working, that means we are not allowing them to do their constitutional function. Similarly, suppose some records have to be given, suppose some secret document has to be given, or some confidential document has to be given, please give. Only thing is, you take Xerox copies and then keep with you, inform your superior officer, and then take that, and then the original file, how many, what is this? Is it a secret file or it is a confidential file? How many folios are there? Everything is Xerox it, keep it with them, original file you can keep, so that your other work can be done without any problem or delay. So this is how it should be done. Suppose if you won't give, what will happen? Suppose some demurrage and warfare files, whatever remission was given, sometimes commercial department will not give. So, or some voucher requisition will be there. So that voucher requisition, suppose our accounts department has not complied with, then all those mandates, they will be calculating and they will take certification from our accounts department, stating that these many mandates, because of the not making available those documents, and these many mandates have been lost. So we can all this can be avoided. So as I was making a mention, CAGI, it is the apex body, and for and on behalf of him, under his guidance and control, Deputy CAGI or DAI we call him. So he will be working, and he will be assisted by DG Railways and DG Railway Board, and at the zonal level, Principal Director of Audit and or Director General of Audit, nowadays it is also being called. So Director General of Audit or Principal Director of Audit will be there, and Director of Audits or Deputy Directors, Senior Audit Officers, Assistant Audit Officers and Auditors. This is the organization setup in the railways as far as CNDG organization is concerned. Having known about this, now sometimes in the examination also they will be asking, audit is a fifth wheel, please comment. Or do you think that because the accounts organization is functioning efficiently in railway, can audit department be dispensed with? For which we have to say that constitutional provisions we have to invoke, because the organization, it is created out of a constitutional authority, it is a constitutional body, therefore its functions cannot be belittled or it cannot be dispensed with. Then what happens to the accounts department? Accounts department, at the best, it is the management, part of management. It gives the financial accountant, or management accountant role will be doing. As any organization will have these two posts, we do that. We render financial advice, we do account keeping. So this is the main difference between the accounts department of railways and the CNDG organization. And so by invoking constitutional provisions, you can emphatically say that it cannot be dismissed with. And one more point is, their duty is ex post facto. Normally we call it as ex post facto, whereas our duty is concurrent. All our check will be 100% pre-check. What they do is, after event is over, they take files, they take our vouchers, and then they do the check, or they go for inspection, take files, and then they do check. This is how they do. But what we do is internal check, and it is pre-check. Before the event takes place, they come for concurrence, and they, before the claim will be sent to us, and claim also will be checked, and payment will be arranged. In between, our finance members will be there in the tender committees. So all these things will be there. Whether any work, if it is not coming in the pre-check, we will do post-check, and we have post-check provisions also, where FNCO has, or PFA has said that these many, because the number of transactions are, volume is less, so therefore let us give post-check, then we will do post-check. Say for example, our repressed cash, we are doing post-check, it is not pre-check. The payment will be arranged, then we will be checking that and recouping. So this is how we will be doing. So by this, why accounts and why audit? So this, you should be in a position to clearly imprint in your mind. Even executive, when they say, sometimes in the meetings also, they may say that, nahin, ye pura kaam agar unhe kare to usko pata chalega. Kyun unhe karna? Kaam karne ke waste hum hai. We are executive people. So our job is to do the job, and their job is not to do your job. Their job is to find fault with the system. So therefore, we should appreciate and we should tell the executive that no, it is their job is entirely different. After all, where from they are taking the material? They are taking the material from our records. After all, where from, with reference to what they are checking? They are checking with reference to our codes, with reference to our instructions, with reference to our manuals, with reference to our instructions. Who has given all these? It is we. It is we have written that I will do POH in so many days. What they will be questioning? Why you could not do in so many days? That's all. Or you have done POH, but that was not made available to the open land organization for utilization. Why there was delay? These are all the things that they will push. So any leakage, this is how they will do. Their job is meant for such thing only. So we have to appreciate, and please let the executive also, if anywhere any comment is there, we have to state CNDG organization as a guiding factor only. If any mistake is done, yes, we are there to rectify them. After all, what they are doing, they are focusing, they are making the searchlight and then showing here there is a problem. So you look at it, and then whatever possible thing is there, you do it. Otherwise, you say that yes, this cannot be done. So this is how the audit reports will be replied. I'll come to that later. But why I'm telling is, the significance of audit, it can be seen by the status of that CNDG also. If you look at the CNDG, he will be, of course, ex-IAS officer will be there, and he will be under the seal and signature of President of India, he will be appointed, and he will be on par with Supreme Court judge. That means if you, even if you want to remove him, on par with Supreme Court judge, how the action has to be taken, similar action has to be taken. It cannot be because he is finding fault, because finding fault is his job. So can I remove? No, it cannot be done. Because he is having the status of the Supreme Court judge. And one more point is salary, retirement, pension benefits, whatever is there, they cannot be changed adversely, which will affect adversely to the incumbent. So during the tenure, you cannot touch his salary, retirement benefits and pension benefits. You can say, no, I will cut 10%. No, it is not possible. Outwards, yes, you can do, but during his tenure, it cannot be done. Then he cannot be, after demitting the office, he cannot work in under government. He cannot take any salary from government of India, that we call it as office of profit. No office of profit he'll be taking under government. So these are all the protection that is given in the constitution. And one more point, you will observe that all his administrative expenses, they are not subject to vote of parliament. Our pay and allowances are subject to vote of parliament. His administrative expenses, they are not subject to vote of parliament. Tomorrow I cannot say, no, I will not pay. No, it is not possible. Because the administrative expenses of CNDG, in the court itself, it was written that they are to be treated as charged expenditure. So when it is charged expenditure, it is sanctioned by president. Even though we take from Consolidated Fund of India, it is not voted expenditure. It is charged expenditure. So this is how we have to treat. So this is all these are the protection that is given by constitution, because they have to give a free and fair view of the events that are taking place in the organization, in the government. Then when we too have took oath of office when we joined the railways, DNDG also will take oath of office. What he will say? Under constitution, I will protect the constitution. Without free or ill will, I will work. That is the oath of office. And protect the constitution, uphold the constitution. That is what it is written. So he will do that. So we all these things, it will help the CNDG to write freely and fairly, without fear or without favor, without ill will. He can do the reporting system. And most importantly, the scope and extent of audit, it is entirely left to him. Suppose it is a theme-based report on a particular topic, if they take on all India level, how it will be done, how many years it should be done, or how much money value should be there, everything it is left to CNDG organization. Suppose it is a draft para, how many years they have to check, and how much money value worth should be there in that audit objection, it is left to them. And what are the topics they have to be selected, it is left to them. So this is how they do their check. But whatever, suppose any particular policy, if they want to do, yes, they do the policy check. And then that policy check, and all over India, all over Indian Railways, if they want to do, they conduct the performance audit. So when they do the performance audit, they will conduct entry conference, they will conduct exit conference, entry conference level, at AGM level they will conduct, and all our PHOD or HODs they will attend, and then whatever cooperation that is required, they will seek. And what are the objectives with which that particular topic was taken, they will discuss, and all the templates will be ready by that time. And they'll tell this within these 3 months or 4 months, you know, we have to complete. So definitely all possible extent of help that is required from railway, we will be extending. And then by end of the 4 months or 5 months, they'll complete the report. And then they will seek, we want to hold exit conference. So this entry conference and exit conference, these are the hallmark of the performance audit. They'll do that and then they give the report, and suppose our PHODs say something, and they will take that also into view, and then they'll give team-based audit report or performance audit report. And these team-based audit reports or performance audit reports, the Railway Board already made it clear that they should be dealt on par with draft para. So this is how it will be done. Then, so that is why this audit CNAG, it is independent, it presents free and fair view of events, and it is a constitutional requirement. It cannot be just brushed aside. And one more point is that the CNAG organization, it assists the PAC in examining the government accounts, because our government accounts are scrutinized by CNAG organization, and the parliamentary control, it has to be completed. So that circle has to be completed. Therefore, whatever we have spent or whatever reports they have generated, and out of that, a few items will be selected by PAC, and they may ask for oral evidence of higher officials. They assist that, and based on that, they give the report also. So that report of PAC, it is recommendatory in nature. It is not mandatory. It is recommendatory in nature, and the respective ministries, they will go into the recommendations. पूरा पढ़ने के बाद क्या करना है, अगर कुछ हमारा जो इंफॉर्मेशन जो जो इंस्ट्रक्शंस है वो चेंज करना, हमारा कोडल प्रोविजंस चेंज करना, जो पॉलिसी रेलवे रेलवे को नुकसान कर रही तो चेंज बदलना. सो दीज आर ऑल द थिंग्स दैट ऑलवेज विल कीप इन माइंड व्हेन वी स्टडी द पीएससी रिपोर्ट्स. ओके, सो डीजेआई, आई सेड दैट या because this organization we have given, and their responsibility is almost CNAG responsibility only, preparing audit report for railway. This already I told. So the object of statutory audit is that whatever system that is available in railway, it is suitable, then internal checking mechanism is sufficient. That means it will unearth the frauds that may take place. Then efficient maintenance of accounts, then financial interests of the railway are protected. That means there are systems are in place, and then this objective, it will be achieved by means of two ways. One is by doing the voucher check. They give requisition. We knew that we are having in our railway courts, it was clearly mentioned the periodicity of destruction of old records, and each of the document, each of the voucher for how much period we have to preserve. So when an instrument has been paid, then that will become a voucher. So that voucher preservation is our responsibility. So all the vouchers they will take because from accounts department. Because once payment is done, then the voucher will come back to accounts and will be preserving. Our record sorter will immediately give that voucher to them. All the requisitions, it is our responsibility to see that the vouchers, whatever requisition by audit, they are given. Then they will check, and if any mistakes are there, they will communicate those mistakes. Similarly, another method through which they get this object of statutory audit, whatever I have told, they will be doing through inspections. They go to the inspection various offices. So how do they go? They go to the offices by means of they draw the program, just like in our accounts department how we draw the inspection program. They also draw the program by month of January or so. So before that, we will write it to all the executives how many offices were closed and how many new offices have come up, so that information will be given. So there are instructions even in our accounts, for our accounts department also, there are some instructions. So as soon as a new office has come, so that has to be visited by our accounts team within 3 months, because we have to guide them. And in our accounts team also, senior section officers who are experienced, they will be sent to that office to guide them. So these are the same thing. Even audit also, when a new office come up, they may select that office for inspection. Whenever this inspection program, they will send it to accounts department also. And in accounts department, we will also have, by that time, our accounts program also ready to take the approval of PFA. So we will see that same office is not being inspected by audit as well as our accounts team. So generally we will change our program, and then later on in the next month or so, that program we will be keeping, and then accordingly their program will be vetted by us. Then that inspection will be done. As the inspection is concerned, whatever facilities we have to provide, those facilities need to be provided, and we will be, our accounts department will be the liaisoning department between executive and accounts department. So whenever they want to go for inspection, they will write a letter, and we will also advise the executive. And at the end of the day, they will be giving draft observation slips. And before the team leaves, if they give reply, they will not point out, or otherwise they will point out in their inspection reports. So this is how it will be done. So having said that, when they do the audit, you knew whenever any proposal comes, we will view with finance angle. Suppose any file is taken by vigilance department, they will go for vigilance angle. Similarly, suppose you sent for law legal vetting, they view it in legal angle. Similarly, whenever you send any whenever audit taken up, they view with audit angle. So what is this audit angle? What is the purpose they have? That is threefold purpose they have. One is accountancy audit. That means arithmetical accuracy of the vouchers or documents, whatever it, the vouchers are there, they will verify that. Any mistake is there, they will point out. Another one is administrative audit. Kiska sanction lena hai? Kiska sanction liya? Nahi to, ye वो भी वो लोयर अथॉरिटी के रूप अंदर आने के वास्ते ने स्प्लिट किया होगा सेम वर्क विद नेम चेंज और स्टेशन चेंज दे मे हैव गिवन सो दैट आल्सो दे विल पॉइंट आउट सो एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ऑडिट दे विल डू सो फॉर दैट पर्पस इट इज नेसेसरी टू इंस्ट्रक्ट फॉर इंस्ट्रक्शन नॉट रिक्वायर्ड बट द एग्जीक्यूटिव ऑफिस ड्यूली दे फॉलो एंड इन अकाउंट्स ऑफिस ऑल्सो वेर एवर सैंक्शंस वी गिव we will follow that the sanction is marked to audit department. That is most important. Then third purpose is the appropriation audit. This is as a part of parliamentary control, reporting back to parliament. So whether the money has been spent on the same purpose, and the reappropriations, if any done, they have been done correctly, and there are no irregular wherever some excess expenditure is incurred, and that has to be regularized. So that will be done through the appropriation audit. So these are the threefold purpose that is done. And audit is done on sanctions, as already said, then tenders, accounts and records and reports, and initial records of the executive offices. And one more important point is their expenditure of our railway audit. It will be a miscellaneous expenditure. So under Major Head 3001, this will be projected, and for railway audit, we will be the associate finance for everything payments. Then, if the communications from audit, normally we call them as, collectively we call them as audit objections. All of you aware, what are the audit objections? Number one, special letter, any matter of importance, and if they want to take up this particular matter to a higher level, then they will write as a special letter, and it will be addressed to general manager and copied to PFA invariably, and later on copy to the concerned executive also they will be giving. And we have to give importance to the special letter, and proper reply also, we have to keep that. It is a potential case for draft para. Then in such cases, you have to be very, very careful while sending the reply to audit or executive also, they should be careful while giving reply to special letter. So, okay, once you give satisfactory reply, then we will be getting closure advice from them. It is only, they highlight only one aspect only of the objection. Then audit notes. Second one is audit note. This audit note is given as a result of the audit objection taken on the vouchers taken from our railway accounts department. जो भी वोचेस लेते हैं एक्विजिशन के रूप में लेते हैं तो वो चेक करके उसमें कुछ गलतियां हैं. सम अमाउंट हैज टू बी रिकवर्ड, वी हैव नॉट रिकवर्ड, और सम मैथमेटिकल इनएक्यूरेसी इज देयर बिकॉज ऑफ दैट, सम लॉस वाज देयर. सो सच थिंग्स विल बी एडवाइज्ड टू अकाउंट्स डिपार्टमेंट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ऑडिट नोट. ऑडिट नोट विल बी पार्ट वन एंड पार्ट टू. सीरियस इरेगुलरिटी पार्ट वन, minor procedure lapses part 2. Inspection reports, they are the reports that were given as a result of the inspections carried out in the executive department. So part 1, major irregularity, and part 2 here also minor irregularity, that means procedure lapses or some register to be maintained, not maintained, vice jo bhi hai wo point out karega part 2 mein. Part 1, financial irregularities. Okay, part 2, audit inspection reports, they can be closed by our accounts department itself. We need not send it to audit department for closure advice. We ourselves should get the reply and then get it closed. This is how it should be done. Then a reply to audit objection, whatever is there, because these audit objections are monitored at various levels, part 1 and part 2, as I said, by railways only, and initial reply within 30 days it should get from the department, the executive. And whenever rejoinder is issued, what is rejoinder? On the reply given by executive, if some more observations are made by audit, we call them as rejoinder. So that rejoinder reply should be given within 7 days. And if that is not being followed, then we will be holding bypassing things. We'll be doing bipartite meetings. Tripartite meetings even with audit also. We will be holding meetings, bipartite meetings with audit and accounts or with executive and accounts. But everywhere our accounts department will be there. It will act as a license department. And one more important point, whenever they give reply, that reply should not go directly to audit, and audit also will not communicate directly to them. Everything, it will be routed through our accounts department. Then one more point is, whenever the audit objections record, it will be maintained by accounts department. It is not the matter of other executive. He will not maintain. He will be having his own. But overall, how many audit objections are pending department wise or age wise? That means year wise. If anyone, we have to maintain the records, and then obtaining the replies and putting up and sending to audit. Entire responsibility lies with the accounts department only. Then destruction of old records, whatever they are there, wherever the audit objection is there, we should not destroy it. We keep them separately. Then whenever audit objection is there and that payment has to be arranged later on also, then you tell the contractor or supplier that I am making provisional payment. If the audit objection is closed to the satisfaction, then continuation will be there. Otherwise, we will be recovering. So that is why provisional payment. And all the rectifications in Para 927 or so of accounts department, they are clearly written. The rectification of mistakes that were pointed out by audit, it has to be done. It has to be. Yes, please.
Sir, could I meet all the participants?
Please.
And the interview will
Some disturbance we are getting. Yeah. Thank you. So, this rectification of mistakes, whatever pointed out by audit or whatever mistakes ourselves, that means in our accounts department itself, when you get, then.
Please unmute and continue, sir. Sir, please click left side audio, sir. The screen, left side audio is there.
Okay, right. Now I got. Okay. So, whatever rectification and mistakes, rectification of mistakes are there. So, those mistakes pointed out by audit or pointed out by our own accounts department, we have to rectify them. And there are provisions are there. Suppose the accounts are not closed, how we should do? If accounts are closed and if revenue head, if change is required, what we are supposed to do, and if it is between capital and revenue, how we should do, everything it is written there and we have to follow that. Then whenever you are doing the rectifications and you need to have funds, means you should ask funds also under that particular proper head. Without that you cannot do. So that you please remember that. Then one more important point is the recoveries made at the Institute of Audit. Now in 2017-18, I saw the report around 193 crores were pointed out as recoveries made at the Institute of Audit. Out of that, please remember this, out of that around 93 crores or so, it is on those items which were checked by accounts department. That means those 193 crores or 100 crores, it involves that the accounts department failure is also there, because those items have come within the purview of internal check. So internal check failure is there. So that is very, very major problem, and we have to rectify, or any system loopholes are there, either in IPAS or manually, whatever we are doing, if any mistakes are there, that always we have to redress them, and we have to see that those loopholes are not perpetuating. We have to plug them. So that is our responsibility. Then the replies to audit observations, always I said that meetings will be held, and any document also we can give, and the to the point their reply should be, that always we will ensure, and the coordinated approach is most important for our audit objections to be closed, and railway board audit objections also railway board will monitor, and at zonal level, AGM level, this audit objection closure will be monitored, and at divisional level, DRM level, senior FM level, it will be monitored through MPRs also. Okay. Then any help is required from executive, we should take, and then whatever information reply we give, it should be authoritative statement of fine. Please remember this. Wishy-washy reply diye to wo kaam nahi chalega. It should be authoritative statement. That means tomorrow they should not find fault that, sir, you said that the recovery was commenced in the month of January, and you given reply and recovery was not commenced. So that is why any reply coming to from executive, we should not just forward. We have to verify, and then only we should forward that reply to audit. That is most important. Having said this, now let me go to audit report. This audit report is most important function under Article 151. So that is the most important function which we have, which DAI Railway, he will do, and he will be assisted in for audit report. He will be assisted by Director General of Audit or PDS. the audit reports, they can be classified mostly, we can say, regularity audit or compliance audit. So any mistake, it is localized, then they will give as a regularity audit, compliance audit. And chapter 6 is reserved for railways, and any audit objection, audit report on railway, normally in the CNDG report, chapter number 6, railway objections will be found. So when it is a compliance report or regularity audit report, there the railway reference will be given, gist, para number will be given, and gist of the objection will be given, and detailed weight will be given. So this is about audit report, compliance audit or regularity audit. Then one more type of report is there, classification. It is performance audit report. I said the performance audit report is on the policy that will be done, and I said entry conference, exit conference, all those things will be given. And one more type is IT audit, that is whatever IT initiatives, whatever you take, say IPAS or UTS or PRS, whatever you take. So they do IT audit, and then the mistakes, whatever they are there, they will find out. And most importantly, our financial health of the organization also they will comment. So I said DJ, okay, entry conference already I told. So this audit report, how many phases are, stages will be there? How a objection will become a audit para in the audit report? Do they give any opportunity to railway, or just straight away they will include in the audit report of the railways? No. Normally they give opportunity, sufficient opportunity they give. How it will be done? Now let us see. Then later on I will show one particular example from DP stage to AP stage, how that was evolved, that I will show. Now, then later on I will take questions from you. Thank you. So the first stage of the audit report is draft para. This draft para will come from either principal director of audit, or we can call director general of audit. So he will send one copy invariably to deputy DRI railway, who is at railway board level. So he will inform him. Then this draft paragraph will come from PDA, and this reply to draft paragraph, it is not a reply that can be given just like a special letter, or just like a audit inspection report part 1 or part 2 or audit note. It is not that way. It is specifically designed in such a way only we have to give reply. First and foremost is 6 weeks time is given for giving a reply. So within the 6 weeks of the receipt of it, we have to give reply, and that will be with the personal approval of personal approval of PHOD and personal approval of general manager. That is most important. Why? I told you that any item of the audit report, it can be picked by PAC. When it is picked by PAC, and they take oral evidence from high officials. So therefore, PHOD approval and GM's personal approval is a must. Then I said a fixed pro forma is there in which we have to send a reply for draft para. It is all the draft para, all the audit observation, it has to be bifurcated into sentences. So sentence wise comments, sentences will be there on the left side, and our remarks will be in juxtaposition, right side. And not only that, we have to give certain annexes. What is audit contention? A connection. Hamara railway ka defense kya hota hai? A contention, a connection. Hamara chronology of the events, a connection. Remedial action to be taken or disciplinary action to be taken, a connection. Waisa kuch annexes hai, wo pura annexes dena hi padega. Without that, we will not accept, and that reply will be putting up to general manager, and then that reply after, and one more thing is, this is the reply from general manager. We should think that way. So no departmental, no, this is not my job and this is electrical job. No, that way it is not at all possible for us to tell. So if it is pertaining to some portion is there for electrical department, let engineering people, they have to get from electrical department and then incorporate in their reply. Because railway as a whole, we have to see and then give reply. So that we will be getting and then sending reply to PDA. But while sending reply to PDA, we will also keep railway board informed. So that reply, our reply to draft para, it will be there with railway board also. Then later on, the principal director of audit or director general of audit, they will examine. And if they feel that our reply is, they also go through and they will also make out that yes, it is there, they have given reply, but however, it is not tenable. What for it is not tenable, they will also make a mention there. And then if it is not satisfactory, then you will not get any reply. But at DI level, there will be some minor modifications they may make and then send it as a provisional para. So that provisional para will come from railway board. So for provisional para reply, we will be getting 2 weeks time only. Here also, that provisional para has to be sentence wise, it has to be bifurcated and juxtaposition we have to give reply. And then here also PHOD approval is required and GM approval is required. But only missing thing is these annexures under draft para, whatever they are there, that is not required. And sometimes so here 2 weeks time, that means total 8 weeks time is given. So at for provisional para, whatever reply we give, we will not give to PDA or Director General, we will send it to Railway Board only. So Railway Board, whatever action they have to do, suppose some instructions they have to reiterate, they will reiterate, or if a particular scheme to be shelved, they will shelve it, and in the reply they will be telling that, and then they will be sending provisional para reply. But I saw their audit objection report, we are doing exceedingly well. As far as railways are concerned, we are doing even provisional para reply before the provisional para converted into audit para. For many, almost 70 to 80% of the replies from railway board they have gone. The statistics are available with me. From railway side, we are 100%. We are giving replies, and they are incorporating. Suppose any reply if you are given, then they will say, for provisional para, railway board has given reply and it is not tenable. Or if they are satisfied, they will not pursue further. Draft para stage, if the PDA is satisfied, they will not pursue further. No closure advice will come. However, I want to tell you, suppose on a same topic, another special letter was given and that was converted into draft para, then you can ask PDA to close the special letter. Statistical purposes, they will close it. If it is on the same topic, on the same subject, then provisional para, so the reply will go with the GM approval to railway board. Then, if this, that means one more mock up de chuke hai. Ek draft para ke roop mein, aur dusra provisional para ke roop mein, aur teesra, ye dono mauke hone ke baad, agar audit ne satisfy nahi hua, then they will also say railway has replied or railway has not replied. Railway has replied but it is not tenable. Aisa dekhe ek audit para banate hain. So that is audit para that will be in the audit report, railways chapter number 6 pe lagaya. So that report, it will be tabled before parliament. And this audit para, to abhi kya hua? Caterpillar, pupa और बटरफ्लाई हो गया. सो दो मौके देते हैं और तीसरा मौके नहीं होता है ऑडिट पैरा हो चुके. सो फॉर ऑडिट पैरा देर इज ए वन फिक्स्ड प्रोफॉर्मा इज देयर फॉर एक्शन टेकन नोट. सो दैट एक्शन टेकन नोट ओनली पैरा वाइज रिमार्क्स ओनली वी विल बी गिविंग. दैट इज व्हाट इज चैप्टर नंबर, पैरा नंबर कितना है और जिस्ट ऑफ द ऑडिट ऑब्जेक्शन क्या है और डू द मिनिस्ट्री एग्री, अगर नहीं तो क्या रिमार्क्स है, वो रिमार्क्स पैरावाइज रिमार्क्स हम देते हैं. एंड दैट विल बी डन एंड देन दैट एटीएन विल बी सेंट टू रेलवे बोर्ड एंड फ्रॉम रेलवे बोर्ड इफ दे वांट टू ऐड एनीथिंग दे विल आल्सो ऐड समथिंग or otherwise it will go to CNDG, that is Deputy DAI. So DAI, if they accept it, then saying thanks बोल के हमारे को भेजते हैं, और दूसरा दूसरा कुछ कमेंट्स है वो कमेंट्स भी देते हैं, नहीं तो अच्छा 4 लाख का डिफरेंस है, ये 4 लाख भी रिकवरी करो बोलना है, सो दैट आल्सो दे विल डू दैट. देन लेटर ऑन दैट एक्शन टेकन, नॉट एज इट इज, इट विल कम टू द रेलवे, एंड इन रेलवे ऑल्सो वॉट वी डू इज इन हेडक्वार्टर्स अगेन टू द सेम टू द डिपार्टमेंट्स विल बी सेंडिंग वेयर फ्रॉम आई गॉट द रिप्लाई. So this is how it will be done. Suppose those ATNs were selected out of them, some ATN was selected by PAC. Then that scrutiny, after taking oral evidences, etc., they do this scrutiny and then they give report. PAC will give report. So those reports also, as far as railways are concerned, हमें बहुत बेहतर अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं, especially in the form of ATN. Or action taken, report of the there is report on the PAC report also, we have to give action taken report. हमारा audit पे रह के ऊपर हमें action taken note देना पड़ता है, और अगर कुछ ना कुछ एक action taken note चुन लिया by PAC, then they will give the report. If they give the report on that, for that we have to give reply. That reply we call it as remedial action taken report. PAC report के ऊपर जो भी हमें reply देते हैं, we call it as action taken report, remedial action taken report or corrective action taken report. So this is how it will be done, and with that the audit report is over. Now I will tell you, I will show one, I said just 5 minutes, I will show one example right from draft para stage up to action taken note, how we traveled, that I will show. One example I have taken, I will show. See, this is the audit report. That means already I said chapter 6 mein chapa hota hai. So audit para 6.1 chapter 6 mein hai. So chapter 6 mein report number 14 pe ye chapa hua hai. Wo ye hai ki aap dekh sakte South Central Railway ka ye non recovery bahut sare railways mein ye hote hoga. South Central Railway non-recovery of substitution towards NPS 77 lakhs. Equal amount of matching contribution. Ye nahi hua. So initially how it was done, and finally audit para aisa roop mein aa gaya. To hame kya kiya? Ye aisa abhi butterfly. Ye to butterfly ho gaya. So iske upar kya aata hai? Action taken note hona hai. So wo bhi main dikhata hu pehle. See, this is the draft para, first stage. You can see 2016 pe draft para hua. So draft para mein ye GM ko address kiya hai, aur baad mein PHODs ko gaye, aur wo kaun sa executive hai, wo executive ko bhi gaya hai. And for each and everything, whatever they say, they give key document dete hain. And they said that so much for 146 people or so, we have not recovered the NPS substitution. ये तो draft para बन चुके हैं. तो draft para हमें क्या किया? हमें reply भी दिया. You can see that doctor replied, I said with GM approval I will be giving. So I took the GM approval and kya kya hai usme, I'll tell you. So ek to mai bola sentence wise. So this is the sentence wise comments. Okay. So kya kya hai hame bata diya aur usko annexures bhi rehte hain. Kya kya annexures rehte hain? Annexure ye sentence wise remarks. Annexure B mein brief history of the case. ये तो पहले का, दूसरे का ऑडिट कंटेंशन इन ब्रीफ, तीसरे का क्रोनोलॉजी इवेंट समरी, चौथा सॉरी पांचवा डिसिप्लिनरी एस्पेक्ट्स इफ एनी इन्वॉल्वड, देन करेक्टिव और रेमेडियल एक्शन व्हाट इज टेकन. सो हमें जब भी वो इश्यू किया तो इस वो बारे बता दिया. और बाकी का लास्ट वन इज रेलवे डिफेंस इन ऑडिट कंटेंशन. हमें कुछ भी डिफेंस नहीं है, खाली अंग्रेजी लिखा है. तो दिस इज हाउ दैट द रिप्लाई टू ऑडिट हैज बीन गिवन. देन बाद में क्या होता है, नाउ आई विल बी गेटिंग ए प्रोविजनल पैरा. सो प्रोविजनल पैरा, वो प्रोविजनल पैरा 21, या सो दिस इज प्रोविजनल पैरा 21 2017 में आया. So this provisional para, I said that I will be giving approval for taking from approval from GM, and I will be giving reply in the form of sentence-wise remarks.